tunes from a Teahouse presented by the E Music Company in collaboration with Esplanade Theatres on the Bay. Tonight, we are honored to have with us Mr. Gu Guanren, who will not only be conducting the E Music Company on the second half of the program, but will also be giving us an introduction to each piece in Mandarin, from which I will attempt to brief translation in English. Mr. Gu Guanren is a familiar name in the world of Chinese music. Some of his best-known compositions include a pipa concerto entitled Hua Mulan, as well as General's Order, or in Mandarin, Jiangjun Ling. Mr. Gu is also known for his works in the silk and bamboo style, which we will be performing today. Without further ado, please join me as we welcome Mr. Gu Guanren on stage.
Top prizes in China.
顾客人今天第一首主题是什么？
下面音乐会我们正式开始。第一首作品是《欢乐歌》。这首乐曲结构简练，旋律富有歌唱性，流畅明快，表现了人们在即兴中的欢乐情绪，是丝竹乐队中最喜爱演奏的八大名曲之一。
The first piece that we'll be hearing today is Song of Joy, and it's one of the most famous pieces, one of the eight most famous pieces in the Jiangnan Sizhu tradition, and it has a very celebratory mood to it, and people usually perform it in celebratory occasions such as festivals. 老师，请。
好，请听《欢乐歌》。 张曲是流行于杭州地区的一首丝竹乐曲，抒情典雅清丽飘逸的音乐让我们产生了对乐突乐工霓裳羽翼嫦娥起舞等浪漫而优美故事和形象的联想。
The next piece on our program, Song of the Rainbow Rose, is a popular item that comes from Hangzhou. And this piece is actually inspired by, was actually in the legends from the moon, and is inspired by the white rabbit in the moon as well as Chang. Please enjoy.
请听以上曲。
Thank you.
樊王宫也是六百信奉的一首直曲，它主要是通过调性变化手法对母曲进行变奏。中国传统有一种记谱方法叫公差谱，它的这个谱啊、谱中樊唱名为发，宫唱名为咪，取名樊望宫，它的意思就是用了发音忘掉了咪音，用发音代替了咪音，用现代的话来讲，也就是它转调转到主音的上四度调上面去。此曲变奏手法新颖，韵味独特，人民音乐家聂耳先生把词曲的快板部分改变为著名的明月合奏曲《金蛇狂舞》，深受听众的喜爱。
The next piece we have on our program, 樊望宫, is actually another variation of the six beats mother piece. So, Mr. Gu just shared a very interesting story about 樊望宫, because in ancient Chinese music, 樊 actually refers to the note 发, and 宫 actually refers to the note 咪, and the title 樊望宫 literally translates to the 发 forgetting the 咪, which is, in Western notation terms, Mr. Gu said it's modulation, and it can also be interpreted as performing the same item in a different mood. I think it's the Lydian mood for in this case. And the fast tempo section, this piece was actually used by composer Nier to compose this very popular piece that is always played in Chinese New Year in Singapore, 金蛇狂舞. Let's see if you can spot that later. Please join us as we invite, re-invite on stage Shanghai Changqiao Shenyun September Ensemble.
在民间用以婚嫁迎娶以及祭祀庙会等场合，并且经常是边演奏边行走，所以取名为行街。乐曲从慢板开始，进入中板以后速度逐渐的加快，最后音乐气氛达到欢快热烈的最高点，突然收住，结束全曲。
The next piece on our program, Walking the Streets, is also one of the 8 iconic pieces in the silk and bamboo tradition. And it's actually traditionally played in festivals and weddings, as well as temple rituals. And this piece will start off with a very slow beat, and it will slowly pick up its tempo, and it's very, and it's very climax, it will actually end very abruptly, so it's like a shock at the end of the thing.
Qing Ting, Xu Jian. Thank you. 感谢上海声韵丝竹乐团为我们演奏非常经典的江南丝竹的乐曲，非常感谢，再次谢谢。下面请观众朋友们休息15分钟，以后我们欣赏鼎艺团为我们演奏的新江南丝竹乐曲。
Because our traditional circuit bamboo ensemble music, we now have a 15 minutes intermission. Thank you.
Thank you.
What Mr. Gu was saying just now was that having heard traditional silk and bamboo music on the first half, we're now embarking on a different chapter right now. Mr. Gu is a strong believer of a modernization of silk and bamboo music to fit the style and taste of the modern audience.
我从小学习乐器，也演奏江南丝竹。后学习作曲以后，江南丝竹的美渗透体现在我创作的所有大小作品中。从1982年起至今，我创作了10多首新江南丝竹作品。2014年出版以后，据不完全统计，北到北京、天津、黑龙江，西至新疆乌鲁木齐，南至海南岛，已经有70多个专业乐团、院校、社团排练演出这些新江南丝竹作品，先后由江苏民族乐团、长三角江南丝竹联谊会、上海民族乐团、澳门中乐团、香港中乐团等单位举办了顾冠伦新江南丝竹作品音乐会。
Mr. Gu was just sharing with us his life story and journey into what he is today. He started learning Chinese instruments since an early age, and he picked up a lot of silk and bamboo music along the way. And since the 1980s, he began to write a lot of silk and bamboo music works, and just 2 years ago in 2014, they were actually published into a book. And he's too humble to say this, but he actually had an amazing 70 oval performances, and today the Yi Music Company is glad to be also one of the groups performing his works in an all Gu Guanren music concert. This school was full of praise for the Yi Music Company that he has worked with over this past week. And he said that even though the rehearsal time was short, the ensemble has managed to capture the essence of silk and bamboo music.
下面首先要请大家听的是我1987年创作的绿野。 这首作品在同年举办的首届海内外江南丝竹创作与演奏比赛中获创作一等奖。乐曲生动地表现了江南水乡的美丽风光，以及冬去春来万物更新的景象。音乐富有深情，具有浓郁的江南韵味。
The first piece that you'll be hearing in the second half of the program is a piece entitled Green Field, and it's composed by Mr. Gu Guanren in 1987. This piece actually clinched him a top award at the competition. 老师，请。
请听绿野。 香港著名电影导演许鞍华先生执导的电影《书剑恩仇录》创作的电影音乐，后改编为小合奏的版本，经上海民族乐团演奏，出版 CD 以后广为流传。乐曲继承了江南丝竹的表现手法，旋律委婉动听，配器淳朴典雅，具有浓郁的江南水乡风味。
The next piece on our program is A Walk on Su Ti. This piece was actually originally part of a film music in Hong Kong. And what you'll be hearing today is an arrangement for this particular ensemble. And this piece, besides having characteristics of Jiangnan Sizhu, or rather silk and bamboo music, it has also a combination of orchestration and new harmonies.
请听苏提曼谱。
Thank you.
说的东滩城曲。上海有个崇明岛，是象限的长江口的一颗绿色宝石，是上海的一片绿肥。岛上的东滩是世界著名湿地和鸟类自然保护区。清晨，太阳从远处的江面上冉冉升起，照耀的江面色彩斑斓，近处芦荟摇曳，野群嬉戏，群鸟飞鸣，一幅人与自然共生的生态图。这是大自然的杰作，群鸟的乐园，人间的天堂。乐曲采用了东滩候鸟人特制的鸟哨等乐器，借鉴使用了西岸古乐种打击乐的演奏方法，描绘野群嬉戏的情景。
While writing the next piece, A Morning of Dongtan, the composer Mr. Gu Guanren himself was actually inspired when he visited an island in Shanghai. What he described the Shanghai island was as a sea of greenery and a lot of birds, and that therefore in this piece you'll be hearing some birds chirping in the ensemble later. 老师，请。
请听《东滩城曲》。 是否会有一番别有风韵的感觉呢？
next piece that the ensemble will be playing is Tunes of Intro. And this is actually a medley of two pieces, the first of which is a description of Qing Ting Dian Shui, which is actually a description of a dragonfly creating ripples on the water. And the second part of the piece, Shi Zi Gun Xiu Qiu, is a celebratory section describing a lion chasing after a silk ball.
请听瀛州古调两首。 处处闻啼鸟。夜来风雨声，花落知多少。这是唐代诗人孟浩然的作品，韵略优美，感情真挚，脍炙人口。乐曲表达了这样一种意境：纷纷洒洒的春风春雨，如烟如梦，远近应和的处处啼鸟，婉转动听，烟转花香的烂漫春花，生机勃勃的春天景象，激发了诗人内心的喜悦和对大自然的无比热爱与珍惜。
This piece on our program, The Dawn of Spring, is actually inspired by the Tang poem by the same name. The Tang poem was actually written by Meng Haoran. In this poem, the original poet was conveying a very bittersweet feeling on spring, as a matter of fact. And the composer, Mr. Gu Guanren himself, has retranslated this into the music with a slow and bittersweet first section, followed by a happy and joyous middle section describing the beautiful sights of spring.
是的，请听2010年创作的《春晓》。 新月。刚才前面我们介绍了一首瀛洲古调，那么这个瀛洲新韵呢，是采用了瀛洲古调的部分特征音调，继承其简练清新的风格特点，同时增强音乐的对比度和张力，使古调具有了新的韵味。
Earlier you heard tunes of Yangtze, and this next tune is actually new tunes of Yangtze. And in this composition, Mr. Gu Guanren used some characteristics of the older piece and reinvented them by adding on some more colorful ornamentations and development of the musical materials.
请坐，请听瀛洲新韵。 谢大家。感谢大家的热情，所以我请我们乐队的演奏家们再为大家演奏一首。这个一首呢是传统的三六。我1961年的时候把它改变成弹木乐合奏，现在呢又改回到丝竹乐队的演奏。那么跟原来的传统的三六应该说有了很大的不同。请大家听一下，看不同在什么地方。谢谢大家。 在这里，我首先要感谢上海声韵丝竹乐团的演奏家们，还要感谢新加坡鼎艺团的演奏家们，为我们做精彩的演奏。热情的新加坡朋友们，谢谢你们，谢谢，祝大家晚安。
Right here, as the name is at the studio. Thank you once again and good night.